Okay, so I'm back in Jotunheim. I've just decided to do this one, this mission here, find Thurm's house. And I guess that one's it. Dive in here, go up, swim up to it. And this is looking for a gift. Go get the key. That's the gift.
Thor's bridal circlet. This would be a gift worthy of Gunnlaugr's attention.
And then the other quest, which is find the cauldron. It's right under there, so I'll fast travel. Why is this highlighted green? Is that the base?
Something huge was dragged this way. This card bears the sign of Agid. The ditch was dark, so the cart would break a wheel. This was an ambush. If it was Aegir's cauldron they dragged through here, it must be large indeed.
Follow the trail of destruction. Oh, just this way.
The trail of destruction leads towards that giant root. Of the great Jotun Skrymir dropped here long ago. Maybe the thieves took their burden inside. soft moss all around. Hard to imagine this place once fitted a hand. I should not be seen in this area.
All the walls and floor one colour, it just a bit makes it a bit harder to see.
A missing cauldron. But how did they get it into this cave? That was not there before. Hard to know what is real in this realm of illusion.
Come on. Where is it? Stealth, baby. We'll get that key. Good night. So these little golden fairy floating things, they come around when Jotnar magic. So that's when the reality can change and unveil something hidden.
Too big to carry. But things are not always as they seem in Jotunheim.
So from a certain angle that will appear smaller. Okay. So just one of them remains now. But it's behind some kind of unbreakable glass. So I'm guessing it's part of a quest line. Hang on. Where's the door I can just unlock? Oh, God. Well, I can fast travel to that, to where Sutunga is. Let's not shimmy all the way through there. Oh, fast travel's unavailable for now. So I have to get out of here first. See if I can fast travel now. Yep. Might be too high up to. Oh, down there. That big person there. Oh, what? Did not mean to do that. Okay. Why is she so big? Oh, whoever that is. Is that the leader? The king.
You are small to my eyes, stranger.
Small in stature, but great in deed. I am the one they call Havi, the High One of Asgard. And I come bearing a great gift.
Your name is known to me. But what could mighty Suttungr want that a little thing like you could provide?
Your great cauldron. Stolen by Hymir's sons. Let this offering be a beginning to the end of our hostilities. Such a small thing, yet so much deeper than it seems. Appearances can be deceiving, can they not?
Well spoken, Harvey. Our people may be enemies, but you have earned your welcome here. Thralls, an honored guest has come. Prepare a feast!
I hope also to meet your daughter, Gunnlóðr. I have heard much of her skill in the mystical arts.
She will be toiling at her work, as ever. But be forewarned, she shuns the company of others.
I could summon her to the feast if you like. We might discuss matters of alchemy on the way.
That would please me. You will find her in her grotto, up the path, within the circle of stones. Have a care, though. You are safe in my presence, but you wander Utgard at your peril.
I will be discreet.
And Harvey, be kind. Gunnlóðr is different from you and I.
This is where the remaining wealth is, the remaining bloodstone. Again, this is a lot of magic, you just need to have a look through the correct stones.
What is this place?
Some time ago, we made powerful magic here. We sought to see all futures. But every road led to Ragnarok. Father does not visit here anymore. He sees no profit in it. But I am not yet ready to give up. You are Æsir.
I am.
I have seen images of the future. Heard the voices of those who will come after us.
Voices from in there?
Yes. I leave them words. Little packets of possibility, waiting for unknown ears many ages hence.
What do these future voices say?
They seek the wisdom of the past. They speak of things to come. But even they cannot turn the tide of Ragnarok.
There is to be a feast in my honor. Your father sent me to fetch you.
No, not yet. Listen. I want you to hear the voices. Are you there, Prophet? Can you hear me? Perhaps another day. Another thread. Come. We must not keep Father waiting.
Who are you?
Winter's knife cuts deep, and sky pearls fall thick in this land.
It is cold out here.
How can that surprise you?
I haven't been outside in... I don't know how long.
You are devoted to your work.
Not my work, my responsibility. My people ignore the disaster bearing down on them. Someone must do something. We have long searched for a solution, until the burden of it has bent my mind. I do not think as clearly as I once did.
I have heard there's one method still untested.
There is, but to activate it would mean defiling our well of knowledge, from which all of Midgard drinks. There is no telling the change it would wreak on humankind. It would bring chaos at the least, and I do not wish to hurt them.
Even if it means the death of all Jotnar?
We will find another way. We must. This land is quite beautiful. I had all but forgotten. The vault, wherein our greatest discoveries are kept. Such things would do great harm in the hands of evil people. No stone walls will defend us when Ragnarok comes. All we have built here will be swept away. Into its very walls. The wind and snow have gnawed that tower to the bone. Soon we will knock it down.
Why is she walking like that? Look at the size of the little one.
And hospitable indeed, great Suttungr. None can say otherwise.
And see, your gift stands in pride of place, brimming with freshly fermented mead. Enough for 100 jotnar and more.
This is an unexpected honor. You have filled it already with mead from your vault, then?
No need. It has filled itself. Such is the magic of the cauldron.
Impressive. But what if it should run out of meat?
Do you hear this? Harvey fears he will drink us dry. My cauldron is deep, but my vault is deeper. Do not worry about my stores of mead. I have plenty to go around.
Father, you know revelry does not suit me. Must I attend this feast? I have work to do.
Your work can wait, my daughter. Take a moment. Enjoy yourself.
Father, we have very little time.
Enjoy yourself. I insist. Harvey, the guests are uneasy. They see an Aesir, but they do not know you. Will you address them?
I'm ready.
Now, we will hear from our honored guest. The Lord of the Aesir has come in peace and brought us a mighty gift. Attend.
Yeah, I'm sure that'll go down well.
I am Harvey, deft of tongue and quick of wits, here to spin you a tale.
Your stories are wasted on them. They respect deeds, not hollow talk.
Oh.
Though our people are enemies, I come here to do you honor, for I know that none feast nor fight like Jotnar.
Your words are well chosen.
I could go on, but who wants to hear words when there's meat and mead to be had?
You know your audience well, it seems.
Now we will drink deep and eat heartily.
Let the feast begin!
The guests are not drinking fast enough. Perhaps I can speed things along.
2 out of 3.
Right food will inspire thirst. I should head to the kitchen.
No guests in the kitchen! Out!
See musicians. somber souls will only sip at their drinking horns. Conjure us a tune to raise their spirits.
We are keen, but my harp has been stolen. We cannot play without it.
Who would steal a songbringer's instrument?
There was a group of children playing round us earlier, with mischief in their eyes.
I will get your harp back, and then you will play. Thralls. Humans kept in bondage, bred to serve. Such is the fate of the lowly.
Avi! Show us your might! Beat our champion, and we will drain our horns in your honor.
Bring me this champion, and I will shine my knuckles on his jawbone.
Behold!
Do not mock me. I will not fight a withered old crone.
If you are too afraid to face her, well, that is that.
If she is truly your champion, then so be it. I will try not to break her brittle bones, but I promise nothing.
Who will challenge your champion? And one. No one has ever done that before.
Drink to me then, as you promised you would.
All of you! Empty your horns for Havi!
The mead is half gone. Then Aegir's cauldron can be drained.
Give it to me! Nobody's I want to go! Get your grubby paws off my harp! My turn! My turn! Not you too! You break the strings with your sausage fingers!
That harp does not belong to you, little thief. You should give it back.
What are you gonna do? Fight me for it?
Why don't you give me a real challenge?
All right. You want this harp? Go dive in that mead. Climb as high as you can, though. I want a big splash.
Watch and learn.
Bet they won't do it.
How many broken bones, you think?
50 at least. Maybe 100.
There. Now give back the harp, so the musicians may play.
Ymir's hairy balls! That was amazing! You must be half raven!
Who taught you such language?
Mother? Why?
Champion? Nobody's ever beaten the champion.
Drink in the name of Havi!
Is there any sweeter music than that? Aegir, mighty friend to the Aesir. Are you not sorry to lose your cauldron?
It was never mine by right. Thor won it from Hymir so he might feast in my hall. I only kept it on his behalf. And after that bloody business with Hymir's sons, well, I'd soon be rid of it. I'll have no strife beneath my roof.
The end of strife. I'll drink to that.
And I'll drink to anything.
Come, what can I do to get them to drink faster? Is there any sweeter music than the clash of drinking horns? I should try the archery contest.
Greetings, Harvey. Will you test your arm at archer? You must hit 3 targets in a handful of heartbeats.
I can shoot the wings off a wasp.
Ah, but can you do it while mead addled? Before each attempt, you must take a drink.
I'll take your challenge on one condition. For every drink I take, you take 2.
Ha! That's a condition I'll gladly accept. Are you ready?
Show me those targets.
Then take a drink and let fly!
What target?
Close your eyes, your luck will improve. Fine shot. Now, have a drink and try another. You look a bit wobbly there. Steady eye now. The last one is the hardest. You look a bit wobbly there.
You are a keen shot, Harvey. Your hand grows steadier with drink, where others lose their eye.
Another round?
Not for me. My belly roils like a knot of eels. And I see three of you. I think I should walk this off.
Gunlola looks glum, and she has not touched a drop of mead. Maybe I can raise her spirits.
You're not drinking, Gunlola.
I do not care for it. Drink is the heron that steals away one's memory.
Some would say it frees the spirit of worry.
We call those people drunks.
I see your wit is as sharp as your intelligence.
Wit? I was simply stating a truth.
Let us play a game. Ask me some riddles. I will see if I can guess them.
I enjoy a good riddle. How did you know?
All great minds enjoy riddles. You fashion order from disorder, sense from nonsense.
You have me at that. Very well, I will play.
Give me an easy one to begin.
Would that I had now what I had yesterday. Find out what that was. Mankind it mars, speech it hinders, yet speech it will inspire.
Courage?
The answer is courage.
No, the answer is ale. I thought you would get that, as you seem so fond of it. Would you like another?
All right, I'm ready.
Who is that shrill one who rides a hard road and has fared that way before? He kisses hard who has two mouths and goes only on gold.
Two mouths, only on gold. Two mouths, only on gold. Kiss.
I think I will need to.
Who is that
shrill one who rides hard a rad hard road?
Fared that way before. He kisses hard who has two mouths and goes only on gold.
Goes only on gold. Kisses hard with two mouths.
Rides a hard road. Has fared that way before. He kisses hard who has two mouths and goes only on gold.
An arrow when it. Oh no. What I'm thinking of, like a. I don't know, it's like a standard arrow target, gold in the middle, but they wouldn't have had that back then. Hammer, only on gold, hard road, two mouths. River. I don't know. Maybe thinking arrow, but I'll go river.
A river has a mouth, and sometimes flows on gold.
A good try, but the river's kiss is soft. It is a hammer. One more?
I feel good about this one.
Be prepared. This is the shit hardest yet. White-haired women, servants too, bore ale tub to the larder. No hand turned it, nor hammer beat it. But there, outside the islands, the upright one who made it.
Snow on the trees.
You have a poet's heart, but you should have used your mind. It was swans.
Swans and eggs. What a fucking
well,
kind of shite is that?
Now the game is over. Have I raised you?
That was disappointing. Perhaps.
I need to empty. The cauldron is empty. I should tell Sotunga.
Swans and eggs. What a bullshit riddle.
Sutungar, your guests thirst for mead, yet the cauldron is dry.
All gone? I never would have thought it possible. Gunnola?
Father?
Open the vault. Instruct the thralls to bring more mead for my guests.
Do they really need more, Father? Several are unconscious already.
Do as I ask, daughter. Give them all they can drink.
As you wish. I will open the vault.
None will say that Suttungr is less than generous.
None will be capable.
See, now the door's open. Or is that a shadow?
Helpless to escape it, and we were fated to be here now, together.
You and I? How? It makes no sense.
The Nornir spin their patterns, and we can only surrender. We are entwined, spun together. There's perfect sense in that.
No, you tease and mock, but I do not believe your lies. Your only desire is the mead. You are a thief and an agent of chaos. I'll see you pay for this deceit. Guards!
Sees right through me.
Steal our secrets.
Your guts out!
Shouldn't have called the guards, should you?
Do not do this. You cannot know the consequences. No one can!
Where is it?
Hurrikin has promised answers at the Well of Mimir.
Is there anything else to see?
Guest, and this is how you repay me?
Loki? You should have the sense to stay far away from me after what you did.
Someone needed to warn my people of the treachery in your heart. Suttungur, show this Aesir how the Jotnar deal with thieves.
Come, embrace your death!
You're not going anywhere, Bobby.
You would gamble with uncountable lies!
Wow, where? Take cover where? Can't move.
What have you done with my daughter?
For one such as you. Your bones will splinter beneath my boots.
Oh. What ice is he talking about? Take cover, where? Oh, ah, okay.
Be thankful it was me who took your mead and not Loki. What I do for the safety of the Aesir and Vanir.
You will change countless fates, Avi, but not your own.
We will see. Hiddekin said to find her at Mimir's well. I will deal with this venomous trickster another day.